started to get rough. We were pulled ashore by a fisherman on an island ruled by King Polydectes. After a while, I noticed that King Polydectes wanted to marry Charmelle. He was the meanest person I had ever met. He even held a fake wedding to get rid of me. I was too poor to give him a wedding present, so I offered him my services. He told me to go slay the head of Medusa. No man had ever done this before. It's because if anyone looks into the eyes of Medusa, they will be turned to stone. The goddess Athena gave me the shield to see the reflection of Medusa, and the god Hermes gave me the sword to slay Medusa. First, I went to the Gray Sisters. I needed directions to the nymphs of the north. They only had one eye, so when they passed around, I went and snatched it out of their hands. They ran around blind, yelling, "Who stole our eye?" "I stole your eye," I yelled, "and I won't give it back until you give me directions to the nymphs of the north." They were desperate to get their eye back, so they gave me directions to the nymphs of the north. And the nymphs of the north showed me to Medusa and gave me three important items: a pair of winged sandals, a magical bag, and a cap of invisibility. When I arrived at the island of the Gorgon, I looked into my shield and saw the three Gorgon sisters sunbathing. But then I started to hear footsteps. I looked into my shield again and saw Medusa, and with one swing of my sword, I chopped her head off. I looked into my shield and picked up Medusa's head off the ground. Now it was time to take the head back to King Polydectes. On my way home, I noticed someone chained to a cliff. I went down and looked closer and saw that it was a girl. I took off my cap of invisibility, and she told me that I had to go where I too would be devoured by the sea monster. But I did not leave. So she told me her story. Her name was Andromeda, and she was chained to a cliff by her father to sacrifice her. Then the sea monster came out of the water. I yelled, "Andromeda, shield your eyes!" And I shielded my eyes and pointed the head right at the sea monster. The sea monster stared directly into the eyes of Medusa and was turned to stone. Later on, I took the head back to King Polydectes, and he sneered and didn't believe me. Then I shielded my eyes and pointed the head right at him. He was turned to stone. Later on, I, Perseus, Slayer of the Gorgon, competed in the Olympic Games. I threw a discus and it hit someone in the crowd. It just so happened that the person I hit was my grandfather, and it ended up killing him. That just proves that oracles never lie. Wait, what? Medusa turned someone else to stone?